What's up, guys? Leopold the Brave here, and I have some sad news for Crash Bandicoot fans. Yesterday on the Crash Bandicoot subreddit, we had someone who works on the rumored Crash Bandicoot TV show come out and explain to us that the show was cancelled. Now, of course, at first, no one believed them right away. They were met with skepticism and a bit of harassment, which we'll get into later. But after people questioned them, they went ahead and revealed the pitch document for the series as well as an animation test. And after seeing them, I gotta say, guys, it's real. This person's telling the truth. Now, I'm not gonna link to them just in case there's some kind of weird legal mumbo-jumbo I don't know about, and I just want to be careful, but you can easily find them if you look them up yourself or on someone else's video regarding this topic. But anyways, yeah, the rumored Crash Bandicoot animated series I was telling you guys has been in the works for the past year is no longer in the works. But why? Well, according to the leaker, the plug for the show was pulled about 24 hours before they made the post, so all the information may not be known or out there amongst the team yet. But the assumed reason is Activision being difficult and having creative differences with Amazon. One of the differences is that there is an episode they came up with that Activision didn't really approve of, where Cortex gets turned into a baby and Coco and Nina have to take care of him. And then there was a joke Activision wanted to push, but the team was against it. Activision wanted Mario to appear as a character or cameo, they didn't specify, in a racing segment in one of the episodes. And they did not tell the team how to get the rights or how anything would work or go down or anything, they just kept trying to push for this thing that the team wasn't sure of how to do. So after those two incidents, Amazon abruptly said, "We're done," the team split up and the project died. So in short, the games division at Activision were being a bunch of control freaks and took away the creative freedom from the animation and cartoon team. And from what's been reported in the past, this isn't too much of a surprise considering the trouble Netflix had with Activision on the Skylanders show. And apparently a lot of other networks passed up on this offer too because word got around about how difficult Activision was. So it seemed like Amazon here was their last choice or last chance. Honestly, under Activision's ownership, the chances of a Crash cartoon are very slim now. But as angry as we are at Activision right now, we as fans need to be careful too. Like I said before, when the leaker originally posted, they were met with understandable skepticism, but also a lot of harassment. I mean, to be fair, all they did give us at first was a wall of text and then got mad at us when we didn't instantly believe it. But you know, it's still possible to show skepticism in a nice and polite way. Now, I just observed the post because I don't do Reddit, but I assume that if I interacted, I would have had something snarky to say too, so I'm going to apologize anyways. But yeah, we as Crash fans need to be careful because we didn't believe this person at first and they were telling the truth. And they're angry and frustrated because their team split up, a bunch of people lost their jobs, and a whole year's worth of work just went straight down the drain because Activision was being stubborn. Now again, not all the details are out because this just happened like 2 days ago. But if that's really all there was to it, then this person is understandable in being that angry. So be careful, guys. Us Crash fans have insane power when it comes to the control we have over our own franchise that we love so much. We got Iron Checkpoint creating Crash Team Racing Nitro Fueled over a meme on this same Reddit. So why don't we take that power and use it for something good? I can't link the animation test or pitch document in the description below, but what I can link is a change.org petition. And I know those rarely ever work, but it's worth a shot. Word has already gotten out about this cancelled cartoon like crazy. It's everywhere. So if we speak loud enough, shout loud enough, sign enough petitions, and let everyone know about it and keep pushing Activision, maybe they'll give it another shot. And if they can't bring back this cartoon, maybe they'll try another Crash cartoon later on down the road. And hopefully by then they'll learn their lesson and lean back so the team can have their creative freedom. So yeah, that's about all I have for today's video. It's short and it's sad. But there's gotta be something we can do, so be sure to sign that petition I'd linked in the description below and share these hashtags on Twitter, ResurrectCrashCartoon and InsanelyRobbed. And I'll see you guys next time. Leopold the Brave, out.